Yeah, one of the greatest coaches in the history of college football passed away yesterday at the age of 94. Ara Parseghian led the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame, my alma mater, to two national championships. He did have some Chicago ties as well, spending several seasons on the sidelines at Northwestern, where he took that program to great heights as well. The pinnacle, reaching number one status in the nation in 1962. Joining us on the phone, another legend and a good friend of mine, the greatest head coach in Notre Dame basketball history, and my friend Digger Phelps. Ara, coach, he was a great friend of yours and an even greater man. You guys had a very special relationship. Can you shed some light on what he meant to you?
Well, back in 1965, I was coaching St. Gabriel's High School in Hazleton, Pennsylvania. Also, by the way, the home of Joe Madden, who was 11 years old and watched St. Gabriel's High School win a state championship. But I write Ara a letter at Notre Dame, Tom. I love Notre Dame, the essence of Notre Dame, and what he's doing in football. Someday I want to do in basketball. Well, 6 years later, after that, in 1971, I end up becoming head basketball coach at the University of Notre Dame at the age of 29. He became my big brother, and he also became my mentor. What was interesting, I got that job in May of 71, and in June, Notre Dame back then had their alumni weekend, but on Thursday they had the Monogram Club alumni have a golf outing. So I came out to play in that from New York, where I had been coaching at Fordham University. And Roger Valdeseri, the famous sports information director legend at Notre Dame, and Ara and I are talking before the dinner started that night up in the Monogram Club at the ACC, the Athletic and Convocation Center. So we're talking about the letter. So Roger says to Ara, "Do you think you have that letter?" And Ara says, "Well, look, here's the keys. Go down to my office. Look on the fourth file inside. Look in the crazy letter file." So Roger and I go down, and we go in the office, and we find that letter in the crazy letter file, bring it back up to Ara. And, of course, Raj asked to use it because the New York Times printed it as a go-to story. But I'll finish with this. What became the reality was he was a mentor for me for all those years. But in January 19, 1974, after we beat UCLA, go back to the Sugar Bowl that year when Notre Dame beat Alabama. Now, all of a sudden, they're number one on January 1st. And after we ended that 88-game winning streak of Bill Walton and UCLA's coach John Wooden, we became number one. And that Sunday, January 20th, the football team's being honored. But Vintage Ara invites me to get introduced before that honoring of the national champ football team got done in the ACC before 11,000 people. But that's how he was. He was Vintage Ara, but more importantly, that made the moment for where that letter became a reality from me making basketball number one with football being number one.
Coach, what a great story. I wish we could keep you on for another hour. There's so much to share. We will have you back on simply because you're such a great man, so special to the Chicago fan base and nationally. Thanks for sharing your time and your story about the great Ara Parseghian. We really appreciate it. We'll talk to you soon.
Thanks, Jordan. You take care.